Okay, Raw Mash Challenge number 10. Now, this is going to be a holiday challenge special. I'm only going to give you tricksy questions. I will go through the questions from the last one to explain how they're done. But the basic idea is check back to Raw Mash Challenge number 1 for all the details. But basically, don't use a calculator, it's cheating. Just use a pencil and a piece of paper and have a go. Okay, the junior tricksy from Raw Mash Challenge number 9. As promised, here's the solution. If you haven't had a go at it yet, might as well give it a pause and see if you can do it now. Okay, here we go. Now, with this question, you've got a diagram. What fraction of the area of the hexagon is shaded? Well, if we join up the diagonals, we can see, as we should know, that a hexagon is broken into 6 equilateral triangles. Now, and then if we break each of those equilateral triangles up into 4 more equilateral triangles by joining up these midpoints on the sides of the hexagon, then it should be fairly easy to count how many triangles of each we've got. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, well, let's just number them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 triangles shaded out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, plus the 9 out of 24 triangles. So that should cancel down to 3 over 8, which is answer C. Intermediate tricksy questions from Raw Mash Challenge number 9. If you haven't had a go at this question yet, pause the video, give it a try now. Okay, got a chessboard. You place the squares, so the black squares in the top left hand corner. So if I just mark out a few of what's going on here, so we've got in a chessboard, we've got black, white, black, white, black, white, black, white. And on the next row it'd be white, black, white, black, white, black, white, black, and one more row, black, white, black, white, black, white, black, white. Now, it'd be quite tedious to draw the whole thing out, but pretty much gonna have to figure this one out. So then we do a pattern by placing counters, starting with a black, and then white, then red, and then black, and then white, then red, and then black and white to get the 8 on the first row. Then we start the next row with red, and then we go black, white, red, black, white, red, black, and then we start with a row of whites, then black, white, red. Oh, no, I've done that wrong. After the white, there's a red, and then black, white, red, black, white, red, and then we've got black, and so on. So black, white, red, black, white, red. So it repeats itself on the fourth row. Now, you can see that the leading diagonal from this corner down to the bottom corner is going to be black. And you can see also from this pattern, this diagonal here is also going to be black. So let's just draw that in red. So those are all going to be on the right color. And next to it is the white counters, which is also all the way down here. It's going to be the white counters. Where else is it the same? Well, it's the same here and here. So those two are going to be okay. And so on. And then that white one. So when does it start? So those, okay, the red sort of messes it up, so anything after the red goes wrong until you put another red in to get it back in the right place. So we've run out of, we get the red, these aren't going to work. This one, red puts it back in place, so that one works. There is no more there, they're all going to, none of those are going to work, so all these we can discount. Okay, on this side, let's just run down this side here. So we've got black, white, black, white, black, white, black and white, black and white, black and white, black and white. And then this side we've got black, red, white, black, red, white, 2, 3, 1, 3, black, red, and that's our bottom. So where does it match up again? Well, it matches up here and here. That's the two starting diagonals. And I think that's probably going to be it. So that's going to come down to here, and that's going to come down to there. So we end up with there's one there, there's one there, there's one there, and we've got those. We've got this main diagonal here. Everything after the red here is not going to work until it gets back onto this diagonal. So that's not going to work. So there, I think that's pretty much it. So we've got the three here. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here, and then we've got a diagonal here, which is 8, and a diagonal here, which is going to be 1 less, which is 7. So 15, 20, 23, and there are 64 counters. So B, 23 out of 64. Okay, so we've got a cuboid. Let's just draw ourselves a cuboid, which is a box. We are told that the sum of the lengths of the 12 edges is X. So if we just label them A, B, and C, then opposite sides are going to be the same. So we're going to have 4 lots of A plus 4 lots of B plus 4 lots of C is equal to X, because that's the sum of all of these. The distance from one corner to the furthest corner, so from down here up to there, which is, if we're talking about three-dimensional coordinates, to find the distance between two points in three-dimensional coordinates, we do the square root of x squared plus y squared plus z squared, which are the difference between the horizontal and vertical distances. So in this case, that's just going to be a squared plus b squared plus c squared. And we're told that that's equal to y. So in a sense, y squared equals a squared plus b squared plus c squared. Now, the total surface area, each side of this cuboid is going to be a combination of these things multiplied by each other. So a times b, and there's two of those, one on either end, plus a times c, and there's two of those, plus b times c, and there's two of those. So that's the total surface area. That's what we're trying to find. Now we need to re-represent that in terms of these sort of things. So what we need to do there is to... Okay, now there is a form that we can use to speed this up, but I'm going to pretend we don't know that and start just looking at our answers. All the answers include x squared apart from d. So I think we could probably ignore d because it's not got an x squared in it. X is this, which is, if I factorize it, 4 lots of a plus b plus c. So if I just work out what x squared is, this is what we're trying to find out, the total surface area is that. So if I work out what x squared is, well, that's going to be 4 times 4, which is 16. And I've got this bracket a plus b plus c all squared. And this is where, if you know what this multiplies out to give you, it will help. So you've got a times a, which is a squared, a times b is ab, and you've got a times c, and you've got b times b, which is b squared, then b times c, and b times a, or ab, sorry, let's write it the right way around, ab, and then we've got c squared, and then there's c times a, which is ac, and c times b, which is bc. So we've got that, which looks a lot like that expression there and this expression here. We've got y squared, which is the a squared b squared c squared, and we've got the what's left, which I need to simplify actually. Let's just simplify that. So we've got 16 lots of a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus, and then we've got ab twice, so 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. Okay, I'll run out of space there. So from there, we can see that I can replace the 2AB, 2AC, 2BC, which is what the total surface area is, with x squared, which is all this, minus that y squared in a certain way. So if I divide by 16, so I've got x squared over 16. Okay, I'm going to go in totally the wrong place here. Let's just knock that off a little bit. X squared over 16 is going to be equal to a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus this total surface area that I'm trying to find. So, and this is equal to y squared. So I need x squared over 16 minus y squared equals the total surface area. Put it all over 16 and I'd have 16 x squared minus 16 y squared all over 16, which is in fact E.